Hi guys, it's Shanille Rose. Now, this video is not gonna be like my usual videos because I've just had some things on my mind that I would like to share with you guys. Today is my 19th birthday, and because of that, I've just had some thoughts and revelations that just have been on my mind up to today. And YouTube is a platform where I'm usually using it to share music and music-inspired things and my piano videos and all kinds of things like that. But I just thought that it would be good for me to use this platform for something positive, something that I've learned, or some things that I've learned that I just really wanted to share with you guys. So here it is. So in celebration of my 19th birthday, I thought that I would make a video of 19 things that I've learned in the last 19 years, which most of them have been things I've learned from 18 to 19, but I think they're all things that have stuck out to me in a pretty significant way and have changed my life for the better, and I really wanted to share them with you guys, so let's get started. Oh, and also before we get started with this, I can see in my little thing that it looks like this shirt is like unbuttoned, but this is like the top button, and so it looks like it's just, I don't know, it looks like I'm not buttoning my shirt up all the way. But this is just how the shirt is, and I really like this shirt, so. Okay, anyway. Item number one on this list of things that I've learned in the last 19 years is firstly, just spend lots of time outside and connecting with nature, because sometimes when like I've been sad in the past year, a lot of it stems from things that, like, I don't wanna say trigger me, but triggers are like real things, and a lot of them happen on social media. And it just like, you get kind of in this, I don't even know how to say it, this spiral where you just like sit on your phone and you just get more and more depressed. One thing that has helped me a lot is going outside at different times of the day. One of my favorite things is when I'm driving home from work and I'm closing that night, so it's probably around midnight. And here in Phoenix, you can't really see the stars as well as you probably could in Montana or Canada or something, but I still just roll down my window and like to just feel the air, and I like to sit in the grass even though I hate bugs. But just kind of like feel your surroundings and just kind of analyze like this world that we're living in. Like, there's a sun, like I don't realize, like, or like I don't think people realize how much we take that for granted. Like, the sun is so cool. Okay, but yeah, okay. I already can tell this video is gonna be a mess because I did not plan, well, I kind of planned this out, but not really, so. Oh yeah, I got a new phone case. It was all black before and it's all black now, and that's, I like that. Okay, the next thing is number two. Find a way to make the bad days good. I think there's something good in every single day, and that just goes back to taking things for granted, which is something one of my managers talks to me a lot, that gratitude can go a long way. And I'll talk more about gratitude later, but just realizing the things that make your day good and just really focusing on those things and narrowing in on those things when you have bad days. I know my bad days, or my terrible days, used to be on Thursdays and Sundays, especially Sundays, because Sundays I don't work, and I don't know, I just don't like morning church as much as I like night church, as weird as that is. And Thursdays, I don't know what it was about Thursdays. Thursdays were just weird. But once I realized that Thursdays and Sundays were my bad days, I would find things that I enjoyed about my other days and just kind of implement them into my Sundays and Thursdays. Like, now every Sunday, I journal, but intentionally, that's the word. So I have a reminder on my phone that's called Sunday Reflections, and I basically just reflect on the past week, and it's a little cute notebook. It's like this big. I got it with one of my best friends who lives in Flagstaff right now, but she comes down every once in a while, and we just bought those. Anyway, so I just do my Sunday reflections in that book, and it helps me a lot, and it helps me be grateful for the things that have happened and the things that might happen in the future. Number three is an important one, but you have to be very careful with it. I have, for number three, remove toxic people from your life. So to remove a toxic person from your life, you first have to know what's toxic to you. And I don't know. It can be a whole range of things, from just bringing you down all the time to being more closed-minded and just like putting their insecurities on you in a way. But yeah, you have to know what's toxic to you. But I recently had an experience where I had just made a friend and we were good friends. Actually, this happened like 3 times to me in the past year. I made a friend and it was great, and a lot of it was because I was looking for more friends, so I just kind of set my standards pretty low. But when it got to like my friends disrespecting my needs or my time, it got too much, and I just ended up being upfront. And being upfront is not something I do a lot, but it's something I've gotten better at because of those situations, because I've ended up talking to those people and making it clear, like, yeah, I'll respect you as a person, but I also want respect back. And if you're gonna be toxic, no. So yeah, and it's not about getting back at them or being mean. You just have to realize what's best for you. And if you can't have someone in your life, you can't have someone in your life. And it can be hard, but it just is so worth it in the long run, and really cultivates you as a person. Number four is invest in stocks and bonds and 401ks. Now, this is something I have been passionate about since I turned 18. I remember when I was 17, I couldn't wait until I turned 18 to start investing in just the stock market. I was so excited about it. I have Robinhood and Acorns on here if you guys know what that is, and I've just been speculating for some time now, and get Nintendo stocks. But I love that part of finance so much. I recently just got a 401k, which, if you guys don't know what that is, it's a retirement plan. And yeah, I'm 19, but the earlier you start, the better. And right now, you just put a small percentage of your income that goes towards your retirement, and depending on whether you get a 401k or a Roth IRA or just an IRA in general, you can choose when you get your taxes cut from it, so when you put them in or when you get, like, you withdraw the money. It's just a whole field of things to look into, but it's so worth it. Number five, have accountability partners. When you have bad habits or you're trying to make good habits, it's very hard to be disciplined just solely in yourself. You need to have people who are better at it than you. And this is one of the biggest examples I can think of, is my faith. There's always people that I look at and I'm like, they're so much further than I am. And then I use them as accountability partners, where if I slip up, I have to promise myself that I'm gonna be open with them, and they help me in a very positive and encouraging way to just better myself. Number six, grounding. Grounding is a technique that I have been informed by professionals and the internet that is very healthy for you as a person. So it's basically using your five senses to just kind of take in your surroundings. So if you ever, I remember I had, not a panic, I don't know if it was a panic attack, but there's basically like these things where, like, episodes? I don't know. I freak out and, like, I just start crying, and my face, like, it's the same thing every time. My face goes numb right here and my hands go numb, and like my breathing just gets like really huge and I can't speak. That's happened to me, I think, maybe 3 times this past year, maybe 4, I don't know. One of the times was at work, and one of the things that helps is grounding. So you use, what can you see right now? What can you hear? One of the biggest ones for me is just smell, taste, and touch, just because they're very like tangible to me. Like, I can feel this piano right here. Like, this is a real thing. It's not like up here. This is legit stuff. There's like perception here. This stuff is real. And sometimes it can just feel like everything kind of shifts a little bit when you get panicked and things like that. So grounding is something that has helped me tremendously, just dealing with that kind of stuff. Number seven, this is something that I have learned from one of my favorite YouTubers, Thomas Frank, and this is that he quoted it from someone else, but I watched his video and got it from him, that always remember that someone else in the room is better at you than something, so you can learn something from anyone in the room. So a good example of this is, say you're 19, like me, and you're in a room full of 16-year-olds. So hypothetically, it's very easy to think like, oh, I'm more mature than this person, I'm older than this person, they should be learning from me. But in reality, every single person is more developed in some kind of aspect of character or talent or just traits or maturity than you, every single person. It's just really humbling and good to remember that other people can teach you anything, and you have to be open to that kind of stuff, because you can't learn anything by just closing yourself off and staying in your head, up in your head and in your pride. That's not gonna get you anywhere. Number eight. The eighth thing I've learned in being 19 is that money is not everything. And this goes back to my stocks and bonds and 401ks, but money is not everything. I've tried to detach myself of the idea of how valuable money is, which, yeah, money is valuable. It's trade. It's an idea of hard work, and you get paid currency, and you just use it to get other things that other people have worked hard to make, or services or things like that. But it's so easy to just get all up in the idea of money, like, I need more. Thing number nine, Tinder is not for everyone. That's all I'm gonna say about that. Thing number 10 is that love can be found in everything. So by that I mean, you shouldn't put all your love into one person or one thing. There are so many things, so many friends. Like, I have a really bad habit of, when I get so caught up in something or like a friendship or something that's really important to me, I will put 100% of my effort in it. The problem with putting 100% of your effort in something is you don't have any other effort to give to anything else. And I did this a lot my freshman year of high school, where I had a few friends that I, now looking back, were very good friends, but I just preferred other friends, as terrible as that sounds, and I would just put 100% of my effort and time and energy into that friendship and nothing to the rest. And it's been a bad habit, but it's important to know that you need to equally spread yourself. Yeah, that makes sense. Okay. But yeah, just do that. I just realized I got my numbers wrong, because I can't count. Let me see. So now I'm on, I just said number 10. Oh shoot, that was number 11. This is number 12. Okay, number 12. Do not be a people pleaser. And I was talking to my friend about this, because like, this whole list of lessons that I've learned, like, I came up with so many lessons for this list, but then I realized I haven't even learned most of them. So I had to like take a lot of them out. But this one is one that I'm learning still and kind of getting better at, but like, I have a long ways to go with this one. Being a people pleaser, I feel like I have to have everyone like me. I feel like I have to be friends with everyone. You don't even know how many times at work I've been told, not everyone is your friend. You don't need everyone to like you. You need to be respected more than, you need to prioritize, where am I looking? You need to prioritize being respected more than being liked. So this is for me to watch later in case I forget. You can't compromise your character to please someone else. You can't compromise your morals, your values, your morals, all that important stuff. You can't compromise who you are as a person, because that just doesn't make any sense. You change yourself for different people, and then what if you're in a group with all of them, which was literally my birthday party last year. You're in a group with a bunch of people who know you in different circumstances, and then you're just like, how do I even act, you know? And it's not so much like a being fake thing. I'm not trying to be fake and pretending to like someone that I'm not. To me, it feels very authentic, but it's not right. Number 13, if you like the way someone does something, tell them, because you don't even know how much it'll make their day. And that just goes for compliments in general. One thing that I like to see my employer coworkers do, and just like other people at my work, is if you like a customer's hair, tell them you like their hair. You don't know how many times, like when I first cut my hair, or like just getting haircuts progressively as time went on, I would feel weird about it, and then a customer would come up, like probably not even knowing I just got a haircut, and they'd be like, oh my goodness, I love your hair. And I'd just be like, oh, yeah. But it feels good, like, just compliment people. It costs you nothing and it makes someone's day. Number 14. 14. Politics are not everything. This one's actually one of the very good lessons that I think I can say I've solidly learned. I used to be very about politics, and I'm not gonna state my political views, of course, on here, and I think that each side has their own way of trying to fix the same problems, and everyone has their beliefs for a reason. But I would just get very icky about it. Like, it doesn't matter what side you're on, each side has their insults, and I know I would use my list of categories of insults for the other side to my friends, which most of my friends have opposing political beliefs than me, so I was kind of the odd one out in a lot of groups, but I would be very rude about it. I once had someone told me that politics are everything. It's the way you see the world and just how the world can run. And while that can be true, you can't look at it like it's everything. If you look at politics like it's everything, it's going to completely divide you from other people who don't agree with you. I even feel uncomfortable saying this, because even though I'm not coming out politically, I'm still like saying something that I don't usually talk about on YouTube. But I know I've insulted people and used insults to my friends, to people who disagree with me politically, which is the vast majority of my friends, maybe 90%. I am sorry to those people, but it's also important that I think we all kind of adapt to that mentality, where if you keep insulting the other side, it's not going to do anything for you. Like, what are you trying to accomplish? You get into Facebook, Twitter, whatever wars, and so what? You can't change someone's mind on Facebook. Anyway, that's all for that, but that's just a whole other thing on its own. You just have to be nice to the people who disagree with you. Do research. What I started doing recently is read informational articles about politics that are known for being unbiased. If you read something that's on your own side too much, you start to get really delusional. Yes, both sides have their faults for fake news. If you read the other side too much, you end up just getting mad. So it's very good to start in a very neutral place. My next thing, with that out of the way, is... I don't even know what number I'm on. 15? Don't compare your healing process to somebody else's. This is something that professionals and the internet have told me not to do a lot. You'll go through a lot of things, and some people are just wired differently. You're gonna take longer to heal than some other people. It's not a reflection of how much you suck, it's just who you are. Okay, so I just realized I had sweat stains, so we're gonna go the rest of the video with my arms down. Cool. Number 17. Yes, no, 16? Yeah, 16. Educate yourself on the environment. It's not a political thing at all. Well, it can be. But what I'm talking about isn't. If you can have whatever opinions you want on climate change and global warming, but it's just good to know how recycling works. Honestly, my only thing with that is just know what's recyclable and what isn't, because I didn't until a month ago. So do that. Number 17. I do not like having sweat stains. Okay, number 17. No, yes. Control isn't everything. You cannot control anything that is not you. You can control you. You can't control what other people say, think, or do about you. You can control your reaction to what they do, but that's pretty much it. So sometimes this has been good and peaceful for me. Like, if something really bad happens, I just remind myself, this isn't in my control, don't worry about it. And it actually helps. But it's very easy to get caught up in control and all that stuff. So don't try to control everything. It does not help you. Number 18, do not have milkshakes before bed, especially if you are lactose intolerant. My coworker bought me Dutch last night, and I know that's not a milkshake, but it was a Golden Eagle, and it was so good, but I did not sleep, because I'm lactose intolerant. I think you guys know what happened. And last but not least, my 19th thing that I've learned is Hobby Lobby is your friend. Because you can decorate your room and make it look nice, and it just makes your room very happy. So those are the 19 things that I've learned in 19 years, and I hope you guys like that. It's just, I don't know, I just felt like sharing that because it was important to me, and I'm trying to get better. Okay, the real reason, no, I'm kidding, but I'm trying to get better at talking in front of a camera. I'm trying to stutter less and have a louder voice. Thank you for watching my video. And I apologize for not posting piano videos recently. I've been busy, and I say this every time, and I'm gonna keep saying it every time. But maybe I'll have an upload schedule sometime. But anyway, that's it. Thanks so much for watching, and I will see you guys in the next one.